Facebook coin, global coin, Project Libra, whatever you want to call it, that is going to be the topic of today's video. Good morning, everybody. It's June 2019. Okay, now, before we get into Facebook coin or global coin, let's have a quick look at the markets. As you can see, Bitcoin is pretty much where it was yesterday. It's holding strong at just under 8,000 US. It's been popping over 8,000 and coming back. But have a look at Litecoin. Wow, over 9% growth in the last 24 hours. Now, if you watched yesterday's video where we spoke about Litecoin and we mentioned a couple of things, I know there was a coin flip, whether to buy or sell, but obviously the coin worked out well. So it's just a coin. Keep an eye on it. It's very, very interesting. Let's talk about global coin. Can Facebook create a cryptocurrency? Okay, so before I go into that, I just want to point out that this is my opinion. Don't always listen to what I say. Do your own research. The information that I'm giving you here is what some industry news, some rumors, and what I've managed to research online. It's also very much what I think about Facebook coin or global coin, and it may need a follow-up video for me to just simply come out and correct the facts. But since it hasn't launched yet, we can only really speculate on what it is. Okay, rumor has it that Mark Zuckerberg has been to visit the Bank of England to discuss the creation of Project Libra. He has been in touch with the American authorities, and he has also been consulting with Western Union for readmittances overseas. Now, the first thing about a cryptocurrency is you do not ask permission. That's one of the things I love about Bitcoin. It doesn't ask permission. It just goes ahead. A cryptocurrency cannot be stopped. Now, Facebook coin is simply an add-on to the existing financial system that we have. The coin is going to be pegged to some of the international coins, possibly the dollar, possibly the pound sterling, or even the euro. They also might be pegged to a combination of coins to try and give it even more stability. Now, as far as an investment goes, it's obvious that if it is pegged to those coins, aside from getting a rand hedge from South Africa if our currency had to fall, there's no real investment opportunity there. However, it might be a good coin to simply use on the platform. Okay, now we've seen this in the past. It's not very different to PayPal. WeChat, which is a social media chatting app similar to WhatsApp, uses Alipay. And in the East, they all pay directly through WeChat and Alipay. It is in fact very difficult to use a credit card over there because that has infiltrated them socially. Everyone is scanning QR codes, paying their friends, paying at markets, and making payments all over. Now, the financial industry is making a lot of headway. They are innovating, and there's a lot of new things coming out. There's an explosion of technology. So we've seen Zapper, we've seen SnapScan, we've seen Samsung Pay, Apple Pay. These are all apps that make it possible for you to no longer carry a credit card or a wallet, in fact. You can simply pay from your phone. Now, with Facebook, they obviously want to get their slice of the pie. They see how it's working with WeChat. They see Alipay. They see the profits. And they are controlling a vast part of the social society that we see today. So it is an obvious step and a very lucrative step for them to make a coin. It is not a cryptocurrency, people. Let's not get confused. This is not a coin that's going to set us free. It's not a coin that's going to liberate us in any way, shape, or form. It's just a slightly different system. It is part of the system. I personally will buy some Facebook coin because I like to be up to date and I like to understand what's going on, be part of the new technology. I won't be buying it for investment purposes. I'll be buying it for use purposes. But let's not be confused. It's not a cryptocurrency, as exciting as it might be.